When Apple first revealed the Belkin 3-in-1 wireless charging stand during their iPhone event, I thought it was wildly overpriced. $140 for a charging stand sounds insane, but then after a while, more and more MagSafe charging stands started to show up online, and I started to realize that this Belkin stand has major advantages over the others. When orders opened up, I decided to buy one and test it, and now that we finally have it here in our office, I've got to admit that I'm really starting to like this stand because of the fact that it gives you a high quality all-in-one solution. But before I tell you if the Belkin 3-in-1 Boost Charge Pro is worth $140, let's dig deep into the product itself. I'm gonna split this review into a few different sections: my first impressions of the quality and design of the stand, the actual functionality and the charging speed, how the stand compares to others in terms of value and price, and finally, my conclusion on if you should buy it. Upon taking it out of the box, I was pleasantly surprised by the weight, making it feel very well built and strong. This is important because the stand uses MagSafe, Apple's new technology that's packed into the iPhone 12 lineup, which allows it to magnetically connect to the stand while charging. And because of this nice weight, you can take your iPhone off of it without having to put one hand on the stand, which is one of the most important things to look for. Getting back to the design, I absolutely love the chrome finish on the bar, which feels very premium, and same thing with all of the plastics, they are very high quality as well. The base of the stand also has a rubbery texture to it, which feels nice, and it should help keep your AirPods perfectly in place. The bottom of the stand also comes with the same texture, so it doesn't move around at all while on your desk. Now, just in terms of looks, I've got to say that this is absolutely the best looking stand that I've ever seen, and it would fit perfectly into a modern home. It just looks so minimalistic, not having to have a bunch of cables lying around, and thanks to MagSafe, the stand is incredibly slim and not bulky, since your iPhone just floats there in midair, hanging with the magnets. And by the way, the magnetic connection is very strong, even with the heaviest iPhone 12 Pro Max, so there's definitely no issues with that. I also like how the soft touch rubber finish is also on the iPhone charger, so you know that it won't scratch or scuff your iPhone over time, like we've seen with Apple's MagSafe charger online. One of the best features about it is that it comes with its own built-in Apple Watch charger, which is fairly unique because with most of the cheaper stands on the market, you have to bring your own Apple Watch charger, plug it in and route the cable, and with some of them, you actually have to take off your band to make it work. But since Belkin is working directly with Apple, everything is built in seamlessly. And I like how everything is spaced out perfectly, so if you want to use your iPhone in landscape mode, you could do that while it's on the stand and it won't bump into the watch, even with the 12 Pro Max. Now, as for charging your AirPods, there's a little subtle light on the stand which shows you when it's charging, making it look very clean and simple. And of course, you can charge other things like another iPhone or even an Android phone if you'd like. As for the main power cable, I'm surprised by how far Belkin went to make this look very clean. You just route the barrel plug into the slot and the cable comes out of a discrete slot in the back, making for the most minimalistic look you can get. And it comes with a 40 watt adapter to ensure that you have enough power for everything you need. So in terms of the build quality and the looks, I've got to give it a 10 out of 10. Now, moving on to features and specs, this is absolutely the most feature-packed charging stand for Apple devices ever made. Many other stands require you to bring that Apple Watch charging puck since it's a proprietary connector that Apple owns the license to, but this stand from Belkin has it completely built in. There are many MagSafe charging stands out there and Amazon is flooded with them. However, every single one of them comes with a charger built in that doesn't actually support MagSafe charging. All of them are limited to the same 7.5 watt Qi charging, which iPhones have had for years now. This Belkin stand is quite literally the only charging stand on the entire market that supports Apple's new 15 watt MagSafe charging standard, only because Belkin is working directly with Apple, so in that way it is completely unique. Just for some perspective, we did a charging comparison between a bunch of different charging methods, and as you could see, 15 watt MagSafe charging is much faster than 7.5 watt Qi charging, especially within the first half hour. Now, I actually have some experience with multiple 2 and 3-in-1 chargers. Most recently, I've been using this one that I bought about a year ago. At first, everything worked fairly well with the standard 7.5 watt Qi charging, but over time, I started waking up to an iPhone that didn't have charge at all, which is extremely inconvenient and annoying. So I started to make sure that I had a perfect placement on the stand every time, and at times, I still woke up to a low battery. I then realized that my stand would only reliably charge 2 of the 3 devices at once. So when I'd set my iPhone down with my AirPods and watch, one of the two would often stop charging, and at times that would still happen with only 2 devices. So that's exactly why I decided to pay $140 for this Belkin charger and give it a chance. Yes, it's expensive, but I know that Belkin is working directly with Apple, so I shouldn't have to deal with those reliability issues anymore. And as a plus, I get full 15 watt MagSafe charging. Now, with all of that out of the way, I want to break down the value of every component packed into the Belkin 3-in-1 Boost Charge Pro, but first, I want to take a look at some other alternatives to see how they match up. And just for some perspective, Belkin's previous Boost 3-in-1 charger was priced at $140, and it didn't feature a built-in AirPods charging pad, and it only supported 7.5 watt Qi charging, and then an Apple Watch charger. And then also it had a slow USB output for the third, so this new one definitely provides more value. Satechi recently released a new MagSafe compatible charger for $60, but it doesn't support the Apple Watch, and it doesn't support 15 watt MagSafe charging, and it also doesn't come with a charging brick. They also have a 3-in-1 charging pad for $120, but that also doesn't support MagSafe, which is definitely worth $20 more for me. Anker recently released their 3-in-1 charging stand at CES, but it doesn't support 15 watt MagSafe charging, and it's priced at an even higher $160. And here's an interesting one, the wood MagSafe stand from Grove Made. Now, this one is meant to be a decorative piece, just like Belkin's charging stand, but you actually have to bring your own $40 MagSafe charger, which is ridiculous because it's already priced at $120. This MagSafe charger from Mopoint is priced at $60, but it doesn't support 15 watt charging, it doesn't support the Apple Watch, and it doesn't come with a charger. Logitech has a 3-in-1 stand for $130, but it doesn't support 15 watt MagSafe either. And finally, Mophie has a very similar charging stand, also for $140, but that also lacks MagSafe. Of course, there are many cheaper options on Amazon, which I'll link a few well-rated ones down in the video description, but keep in mind that you have to add your own Apple Watch charger, and in many cases, also a power brick. And with that, they don't work super well, especially in the long term, which is why I'm buying my third charging stand in 3 years. And as far as the value of all the pieces that are built into this, they come in at about $100 if you consider the MagSafe charger, the Apple Watch charger, this wireless charger, and then having an all-in-one nice solution that looks great and that comes with the power brick, that's pretty much what you're paying the extra $40 for. So after looking at all of those stands, the Belkin one is actually a fairly decent value with more bang for the buck if you care about having that faster charging speed. It truly comes with everything that you need, all built into an incredibly solid and premium looking stand with the fastest charging you can get, with only one single cable coming out of the back. And on top of that, it not only comes with a 2-year warranty, but also comes with a $2,500 connected equipment warranty, just in case any of your devices are damaged by an electrical charge. So here's my final conclusion on if it's worth it, and it comes down to 3 questions. Do you want to charge 3 Apple devices with 1 product? Do you want the fastest 15 watt MagSafe charging for your iPhone? And are you willing to pay a bit more for a minimalistic and premium design that will likely be more reliable and last much longer than cheaper solutions? If you said yes to 2 or 3 of those questions, then I would say that the new Belkin 3-in-1 wireless charging stand is definitely worth buying, especially since we know that MagSafe is very important to the future of the iPhone. Personally, I can already tell that my $140 was well spent, knowing that I'm not gonna have any weird charging issues going down the road like I did with my previous cheaper third-party charging stands, and that I'll be using this for many years like the original Belkin charging pad, which still works great, while multiple cheap ones have become unreliable. Hopefully you guys enjoyed this review, and if you did, you can find links to this Belkin charger and a few others down in the description below, and let me know what you think down in the comments section. You guys can click that circle above to help us reach 600,000 subscribers before our 2-year mark in March, and check out one of those great videos over there. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you in the next video.